Hi, welcome back to online classes. My name is Lavanya, English teacher, KGBV School, Ellenpeta. Hello children, good afternoon. How are you today? I hope you are all safe at home. Today, this lesson is all about verbs. In this lesson, I will teach you the different types of verbs that we have in English. And I will also show you how to avoid some common mistakes with verbs. First, we will start with state and action verbs, and then we will look at main and helping verbs, and then we will turn to regular and irregular verbs, and finally we will discuss transitive and intransitive verbs. But before the discussion, we should know what is transitive and action verb, and what is main and helping verb, and what is regular and irregular verbs, and what is transitive and intransitive verbs. Okay, state verbs are shows a situation, and we do not use ing form with state verbs, and action verbs expresses physical activities and processes. Then main verbs or helping verbs. Be verbs, do verbs and possessive verbs are the most important helping verbs. And what are the be verbs and do verbs and possessive verbs? Be verbs are am, is, are, was, were. And do verbs are do, does, did. And possessive verbs are have, has and had. Then we have modal verbs. Modal verbs are another type of helping verbs. Modal verbs are will, would, shall, should, can, could, need, dare, used to, ought to, may, might. These are all modal verbs. Then regular or irregular verbs. The past and the past participle form of irregular verbs do not guess. We learn them through experience. Then transitive and intransitive verbs. Transitive verbs can take an object. Intransitive verbs do not take an object. Okay. But before the discussion, we should know what is a verb. Here is a question. What is a verb? A verb is just a word that shows an action or a state. Here, state means a situation. And actually, those are the two types of verbs. One is state verb and other one is action verb. These verbs are also called stative or dynamic verbs. But the meaning is the same. Okay children, here we will start with state verbs or stative or action verbs or dynamic verbs. Main or helping verbs. Helping verbs are also called auxiliary or modal auxiliaries or finite verbs. For example, be verbs, do verbs, have are called helping or main verbs. Here some modals: can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should, must. These are all modal verbs. Then the third one is regular or irregular verbs. Then the fourth one, transitive and intransitive verbs. Okay children, take out your notebooks and note down this in your notebook. Okay children, so first of all, what is a verb? A verb is just a word that shows an action or a state. Here A state means a situation, and actually those are the two types of verbs. They are state verbs and action verbs. Sometimes they are called stative and dynamic verbs, but the meaning is the same. Okay, children, here is a question. Here is a question again. What is the difference between these two? Here, these two means the verbs we discussed already about state and action verbs. These are the two differences. But we should know about what is the difference between these two. The difference is that action verbs expresses physical activities or processes. For example, run, sit, stand, climb, these are all shows physical activities. So these examples are in action verbs. But a state verb is that expresses a situation. For example, verbs like be, have, think, like, and won't are all state verbs. Now, here is some examples. When I say I have a large family, here I am using the state verb have. I have a large family. Here I am using the state verb have. That means I am not talking about doing any physical action. I am just telling you about a situation. Next, in the second sentence, Julia likes ice cream chocolate. Here, the second example, Julia likes chocolate ice cream. The second sentence gives you just information about, but it's a state verb. Why is this difference important? Because there is an important rule in English that you should know, and the rule is state verbs cannot be used in ing forms. When you want to use a continuous form, you can only do that with action verbs. Let's look at a couple of examples. Now we can say the children are playing in the park, or the second sentence, who is shouting? Both of these sentences are correct. Both of these sentences are correct because the verbs play and shout are physical actions. So we can use ing form with these verbs. But we cannot say I am having a large family, or Julia is liking chocolate ice cream. These two sentences are wrong. Both of these sentences are wrong. They are common mistakes that some of us make. Please don't make that mistake and remember, no continuous forms with state verbs. You can only make ing forms with only action verbs. Okay, let's now move on and talk about main and helping verbs. Main and helping verbs. Helping verbs are also called auxiliary verbs or finite verbs. Then, when a verb is used in a sentence, it cannot be used in two ways. It can either be used as the main verb of the sentence or it can be a helping verb. That is, it can help the main verb. The most important helping verbs are be verbs, do verbs and possessive verbs. Let's look at some examples with these sentences. Ravi is working now. In this sentence, there are two verbs. Can you tell me which are the two verbs? Is and working are the two verbs. Which is the main verb? The main verb is working. And what about is? Is the helping verb. Is the helping verb that shows the tense of the sentence. We know that Ravi is working now because we said is. If I said Ravi was working, if I said Ravi was working, you know I am talking about the past. So the helping verb is showing the tense. What are the things that helping verbs can do? They can also help us to form negative sentences. For example, Ravi is not working. This sentence is in be negative. Then form questions. For example, is Ravi working now? This is a be question. In all of these three sentences, the helping verb is be or be. We are saying is, but that's just a form of the verb to be. We say I am, you are, he is, she is, it is, etc. The verb do and have can also be helping verbs. For example, I don't play golf every weekend. And maybe I am talking to my friends and my friends say, hey, you play golf every weekend, right? And I say, no, I don't play golf every weekend. I play tennis. For example, so didn't, is, do not. That is the negative form of the verb. Do and it helps me to make a negative, or my friend could ask, do you play golf every day? Every weekend? That's a question. Let's look at an example with verb have. We have visited UK 4 times. Here we know that the main verb is visited. But can you tell me what is the purpose of using have in this sentence? Now, if I told you we visited the UK last year, in that sentence, I am talking about one single experience. That is my visit last year. But when I say we have visited the UK 4 times, when I am not talking about any single experience, but I am talking about life experience. That is, in our lives we have visited the UK 4 times. That's what the verb have help us to do in this sentence. Okay, so that's how be verbs, do verbs and possessive verbs are used as helping verbs. But take a look at this next sentence. We have a car. Now both of these sentences use the verb have, but do you notice a difference between them? The difference is that the first sentence uses have as a helping verb, but the second sentence use have as the main verb. You might be thinking, how is that possible? Because have is a helping verb, right? True, but in some cases be verbs and do verbs have can be used as main verbs. Now in this sentence, have is used to mean own. We own a car is what I am saying. So in that way, in some cases these can be used as main verbs, but most of the time they are used as helping verbs. Okay, another type of helping verb is models. Models are these words: can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should, must. I am sure you know these words. Models help us to express mood in a sentence. Here, what is mood? In grammar, mood means the attitude of the speaker. Here is a question. What is a mood? In grammar, mood means the attitude of the speaker. It talks about possibility in future and ability. For example, it may rain today. Models can also express ability, like my sister can play the guitar. The second sentence. In that sentence, play is the main verb and can shows ability. Or if I said, you must not smoke here, what is the mood I am trying to convey? I am using the modal verbs must in the negative. Must not, to show that you don't have permission. You must not smoke here. So in that way, modal verbs help us to express mood in a sentence. So that's our discussion of main and helping verbs. Let's now move on and talk about regular and irregular verbs. To understand these, you need to know a little bit of background information, and that is that in English only verbs can have tenses. Of course, you know about past tense, present tense and future tense, but to make tenses, we change the forms of verbs. Do you know how many forms of verbs are in English? There are 5 forms. We call these infinitive or base form, and present tense form, the past tense form, past participle form, and ing form or continuous form. Let's take the example of irregular verb. To cook, its present tense form is cook or cooks. Its past form, cooked. and its past participle form also cooked as well. And continuous or ing form is cooking. Then the second one, to go, is the base form or infinitive. Its present tense form is go or goes. When we use goes, if the third person is singular, it is he, she, it, we may use verb with s. Then the past form of the verb go is went. Then the past participle form is gone. Then the continuous form is going. Then the third one, to be, and its present form is am, is, are. Its past form was, were. Past participle being, in ing or continuous form being. Then the word to read is base form. Its present tense form is read or read. Its past participle form is also pronounced as read, but the spelling is read. And in past participle, read in spelling, but pronunciation is red, like color red. And in continuous form, reading. So you might be thinking, how can I grasp the past and past participle forms or irregular verbs? Regular and irregular verbs, that verbs change as per tense, and they are divided into three main forms, which are base form and past form, past participle form. Now let us look at some examples. Arrive or jump become jumped in past form and jumped in past participle form as well. Arrived in present tense, arrived in past tense, and arrived in past participle. We can do one more example. Drink in base form or in present tense, drank in past tense, drunk in past participle. Now, as you can see, for converting the word arrive, past and past participle form, we used ed. But for converting the word drink, we didn't use any such pattern. So the verb which is following the pattern for conversion from present to past and past participle is a regular verb, and the verb which is not following any pattern for conversion from present to past and past participle is regular verb. Let's define them. The verb which is following the pattern for conversion from present to past and past participle form is a regular verb, and the verb which is not following any pattern for conversion from present to past and past participle form is irregular verb. But based on the information of the past and past participle form, verbs are divided into two types: regular verbs and irregular verbs. Regular verbs are that follows fixed pattern while conversion from present, past and past participle forms. Irregular verbs that do not follow a fixed pattern while conversion from present to past and past participle forms. Regular verbs are formed by adding d, ed to the base form. Irregular verbs do not follow any such pattern and cannot form just by adding the specific character to the irregular verbs. Let's now understand how regular verbs are formed. The first one is, most regular verbs are formed by adding ed to base form. See, for example, jump. The word jump is the base form, and its past form is jumped, and past participle form is also jumped. And here the another example, call. Call will become called in past form and called in past participle as well. And look will become looked in past form, looked as well in the past participle form. Now there are some cases we need to modify some parts of the words when we are adding ed. Second one, some regular verbs formed by adding d to its base form. If a verb ends with e, we simply add d to convert it to the past and past participle form. Here is a word like, like. This word is ends with e. Like become liked in past form as well in past participle form. Then agree will become agreed in past form, agreed in past participle form as well. Then die will become died in past form, died in past participle form as well. Let's look into one more case. Regular verbs formed by adding ied to the base form of the verb. If the verb ends with consonant letter y, we replace y with I and ed is added. For example, cry becomes cried by replacing y into I and ed is added. And cried in past participle form as well. Let's look into some more example. Study will become studied in past form, studied in past participle form as well. Then marry will become married in past form, married in past participle form as well. Then say will become said in past form, said in past participle form as well. Then the last example, pay will become paid in past form, paid in past participle form as well. Let's now look into irregular verb. Irregular verbs do not have any fixed pattern. For our understanding, we will divide them into four groups. Group 1 will contain a verbs which all three verbs are same. And group 2 will contain the past and past participle form of verb are same. In group 3 will contain same base form and past participle form. And group 4 will contain all three forms of verbs are different. Let's see some examples of irregular verbs of group 1. All three verbs are same. Here the base form put will become put in past form, in put in past participle form as well. Cut, cut, cut. Hurt, hurt, hurt. And the second one, let's now look into examples of group 2. Same past and past participle form. Buy will become bought in past form, bought in past participle form as well. Feel in base form, felt in past form, felt in past participle form as well. Then win in base form, won in past form, won't in